So everybody, here we are at the 20-gallon Nano, and if you have not known, here in Brooklyn, we are dealing with a crazy heat wave. Shout out to my people out west in Arizona and all of those places that are out there. Like, really, you're complaining? They had 112 degrees for about like 2 weeks. Well, we are getting hit here in Brooklyn. Down here in the basement here where I have a lot of the little tanks, I got an alert from a hydros yesterday that the temperature down here had hit like 89 degrees and the tank was hovering at like 87, 88 degrees. And I really took a hit. So let's go in for a closer look and see how bad it is. So one of the things that separates this smaller tank from the main tank upstairs is the tank upstairs in the living room, I have temperature control because it's in the living room. I have my AC up there. It's on a thermostat. When the family works from home or when they're home, they tend to have the air conditioner on. There's no air conditioner down in the basement, so it gets really hot, and the SPS really didn't like it. I'm hoping that my chalice recovers. Under the blue light, it's looking kind of decent, but when the white lights came on, it looked like it was definitely bleaching out. Same thing with the, you know, my acros here, my stags up here. Let me move this up a little bit. That baby up here I just got from Reefapalooza. I can see definitely that the pink polyps have just about kind of like died off on the front. And it really doesn't look good. I found this baby yesterday, which was that beautiful acro. I mean, acro, my Aiken. It was an Aiken at one time. Now it's just like a dried up rock. It really broke my heart because it was a beautiful, like rainbow colored Aiken. I had it for a couple of months, actually, since like last fall. So this is really the first summer since I redid this tank. And that is one of the reasons that I'm seeing a lot of die-off. A lot of the hard corals, SPS, do not enjoy high temperatures. In the past, I had a nice balance of soft coral. More likely, you know, not only mushrooms, but different soft corals and bubble tips. I had a little bubble tip anemone back there. Anyway, zoas and things are able to adapt. You know, the zoas are really doing well. They really spread throughout this whole thing. They're even on SpongeBob's little pineapple there. They've grown up the side of the pineapple. But the SPS really took a hit. If we go down here, yeah, this is hanging in here. So far, it's hanging in there. I see a little of the polyp extension. It's looking lighter than normal. Same thing with my jack-o'-lantern up there, the jack-o'-lantern. If I get my light, let me shine a little light on it. No, you can't really tell the color from there, but you can see a little of the polyp extension. It's still really, really lightly colored. It still has a lot of its orange coloration. It's hard to see with the camera's phone, but if I angle the light a little light to the side, you can see that, yeah, it did get really faint. They're just hanging in there, man. The tank, I did a big water change, about 30% yesterday. They've seemed to enjoy that and kind of come back a little bit. If you look over here, this is my other problem. Aptasia up the wazoo. It started out with one. And I had been nuking it with Aptasia X. I did a caulk washer, like a hit with my direct little syringe, kind of injected a caulk washer. It retracted, came back with a like a force. So they're definitely enjoying the high temperatures and kind of beating everything over the head. The leather will open up. The leather always does this. It retracts in the heat and it comes back and it shows the polyps. But I'm more worried about this growth of Aptasia and how I'm going to treat that without kind of bothering everything around it. Behind that is also my flower anemone. Let me take the camera and get you a better shot. It's really hard to see it, especially getting the glare and the movement, but actually the flower anemone looks like it's doing pretty good. But once again, look how that Aptasia is reaching down. I'm gonna have to definitely either glue over them or try to really aggressively treat the aphtasia, because they are doing more damage than the temperature. And I really hate for them to get a foothold and start spreading. My war coral is another one that is really taking a hit. Let me get the light out there. You can see it's still got a little of its pink, but this was a beautiful bubblegum kind of colored war coral, red and yellow center, really nice. It actually encrusted over that whole rock there. You can see here, you look close, it was encrusting over the side of the tile and really, really doing its thing. But if you look back there, that is really making me sad. It is vaguely holding on to its color. So you guys that are out there making videos about tank crashes and wondering, you know, what going into those tank crashes and what spurs the algae. I've been doing this a long time, which is another reason why it's so amazing that I took the air conditioner out of the basement and put it in my son's room instead of replacing it. But yeah, I'm taking a hit. I'm hoping that the candy cane hangs on. It's hanging on in there. It's retracting. It's like Rocky. It's taking a beating and it's coming back for round three. I hope that it holds up. The zoas, once again, easy peasy, they're hanging on. But this baby hanging in there too. It just kind of gives you a little lesson on what corals, based on your situation, what kind of tank setup you got, and the tank factors, and just including how you control the temperature and things of that nature, that what coral are feasible for you to be able to keep without having what we call a die-off. It's not a tank crash, but it's basically a die-off. Even this guy looks hot. He looks like he's like, hey dude, we need AC in here. He's standing. One thing that did perform admirably is the random flow pump, that random flow nozzle. You can see it's working really well. I raised it up out of the water a little bit so that it could catch some air from the surface and just oxygenate the water. And where'd my buddy go? He likes the camera, so I moved the camera, he took off. But that has been performing like a champ. It's been adding a lot of circulation to the tank. And I'm just trying to hold on, so I'll be doing some more water changes. I'm venting the room. I set up a couple of fans, connected them to the hydros controller. So there's one over there. I'm gonna add another one up here. And I may just cut down on the white light for a period and try to keep the temperature down. One of the other things which I failed to mention is I had an open top before. Now I have the glass top, which definitely keeps heat in. So I'm gonna put the screen top back up here so that I can vent, just release that heat out of the water column. But one of the downsides is I was evaporating water like crazy. Here this guy is. Does he like the camera or what? Got to come up with a name for him. If you guys know a good name for this guy, put it in the comments below. I love this dude. When I put the camera out, he literally sits there and like sits in that little corner. And I guess that's his house. So maybe I'll call him SpongeBob. I don't know. He loves that house. He's usually in Squidward's house, but today he's in SpongeBob's house posing for the camera. So shout out to Pinplex. Hook me up with those bikini bottom figures. And that's one thing that brings me joy still. I'm still struggling with the tank. Not a first, not a last. One of those things in keeping saltwater aquariums. You got to deal with the temperature. Oddly enough, the 11-gallon cube, no problem. All I got in there is Zinnia. I got my guy Spot over there. And I got Remy in the back chilling. They're not bothered. They're like they're in Florida on vacation. They're chilling. But of course, this is all mushrooms and Zinnia, waving hand Zinnia, pulsing Zinnia. No problem. So easy coral to keep. Doesn't really bother with the temperature. No problem. This tank's definitely in the 85. If I'm a betting man, I guarantee you it's 85 degrees at least. And they're just chilling. So if you want an easy tank to keep, keep Zinnia, keep things like that. Easy to manage, easy to care for, but I'm really sad that some of those stony corals took a hit. I was really enjoying them. They were really seeming to take off. And what are you gonna do? It comes with the territory. I'll monitor the temperature. I'll set up some checks and balances in a hydros, and hopefully that does the do. But on a lighter note, my little 40 breeder here, the just the Fowler tank, fish only with live rock, doing great. Changed water in there. These guys are paired up. I'm hoping that I get fry one of these days. They just been doing that dance for like the last 3-4 months in the flower pot and doing their little thing. I have not seen my one of my darters. I see my little Blinny there, and there he is. That's my other guy, not SpongeBob, but his little brother down there. He's chilling. They've been keeping the algae down to a minimum. I did a water change on this tank, changed some water. This guy's chilling over here, living their best life. And let's look at the temperature on that. This one is 84 according to the digital probe. So this one also glass top. But I had some fish in there that were jumping and hitting the lid, including the Blinny that I just looked at that disappeared. So I'll probably put the screen tops back on here and see if it changed, lowers the temperature. But I thought I'd show you the good, the bad, and the ugly. This is D from Brooklyn. Keeping it real, because it is a real thing. Keeping tanks, you're gonna have problems. People always show you when a tank's sparkling and clean. Dude, we're real people. Sometimes we don't clean the glass. Some it happens. You got to go to work, you got to take care of the family. It is what it is. One thing I am happy and blessed about is that I do have the controllers and probes on these tanks, so that when the temperature does rise, it sends me a notification. I know, oh my God, the temperature is raising way past what it should be. Time to know that I'm gonna go home and do a water change or take action. So all three of these tanks have some kind of control on it. Only these two have heaters and things connected to the hydros. The little cube does not. And part of the fact that they're all covered up, probably keeping the heat in, doesn't help. But if you guys are running into problems with condensation and excessive evaporation, it's definitely because you got open top tanks. And just because you have open top tanks does not mean it's going to stay cooler. I've been running these tanks for the better of 10 years. This one has been running for about three years or so. Doing great. So if you guys struggle with coral, you can always start a fish only with live rock tank. You can keep all kinds of fish. Temperature is not so detrimental to them, not like coral. They deal with the temperature swings. You may see an algae bloom or two, which is not even a problem. But yeah, also a definite alternative to having what we call crashes, which isn't always a crash. It could be temperature, it could be your things are out of whack, your parameters. It could even be excessive salinity, because when you have an open top tank, the evaporation is so far ahead of what it normally is in the winter that you're evaporating out so much fresh water, and the salt water concentration just starts to go through the roof. And sometimes that also causes what people deem a tank crash. So with that, I'm gonna sit back, I'm gonna feed the fish. Look at this guy coming out. He's probably hot too. But I'm going to relax, see the next steps, give you an update on the pond in the next video. Hopefully we get some refreshment from this crazy high temperature. And you guys out west, stay cool. You guys in Texas and out there, take care of your tanks as best you can. But things happen. It is what it is. If you like this content and content like it, do me a solid. Click that like button. Click subscribe. Tell me what you want to see. If you want to know something, I got a lot of years in this game. I learned a lot of things the hard way. I do a lot of things a lot of different ways. We got the freshwater tanks. We got the saltwater tanks. We got breeder tanks. We got all kind of things going on here. And yeah, we got that mess in the corner too. You didn't see that. But till next time, this is D. I'm going to cut it short like there. And keep your sanity, keeping fish, but keep it simple. Don't kill yourself, and you'll stay in the hobby a lot longer. Love, peace, and hair grease. See ya. I'm gonna go cry in private.